I'm Greg DePalma, and you're listening to Dan Shonka's Scouting Section on the Arlettes Football Radio Network, where it's never too early to think about the NFL Draft. On this edition, Dan will break down Brett Hundley's performance in his first career start on Sunday in a losing effort against against New Orleans, and what Hundley needs to work on the most to become a competent winning quarterback in the NFL. All right, Dan, in your 2015 report on Hundley, you said Hundley was hit during his career more than a piñata at a Mexican cartel birthday party, mostly because he was sacked 125 times over his three-year career at UCLA. So what positives and negatives could you take away from that sort of pounding in college, and how could that affect his impact in the NFL?
Well, he's used to getting hit.
That's a good thing.
Plus, he's been behind Aaron Rodgers, so he hasn't been clocked too many times. Although, his rookie year, he really did well in the preseason. And I thought, Green Bay did a nice job. They got him at the right price. I think it was in the fifth round, which surprised me. We had him projected to go in the third or fourth round because he's a very good athlete. And the thing is that consistency, and I was hoping that he would show, more in regards to his ability to anticipate and read a defense and things as it developed. And sometimes the only way you can do that is getting in and playing. And you do it in practice. And of course, he's been the practice squad quarterback and playing behind one of the greatest the NFL's ever seen. I think it was clear that he wasn't ready for the live bullets yet, but very few rookie quarterbacks are. But the young guys have got to get time. We can criticize all the guys we want to. I already saw somebody the other day, saying something about Beathard, in his first start, saying, well, he'll never be able to play in the NFL. Well, he did some good things, and so did Hundley, but it's just a matter of it's their team, and they got to go in and show what they can do, because I tell you, Hundley's got the talent. That is not the problem. He's got the size. He can throw the ball. He's a very good athlete. And like I said, he can take a hit. But the thing is, he's got to be consistent. And, sometimes consistency isn't always there in a player. They're streak guys. Like, they can, go on a streak and really be hot for four games. But then they just might drop off the map for three or four games and then get back. And, what you want is a guy like Aaron Rodgers. When Aaron Rodgers comes out, obviously, what you're going to get.
Sure.
Or a Drew Brees down in and down out. Although Drew Brees threw a couple of interceptions the other day, and I didn't hear anybody, trying to get rid of Drew Brees, even though he had a couple turnovers. And, of course, he's thrown for 70,000 yards in his career. And now I think that Hundley and his pro career has got like 55 yards.
Yeah. What about now? I think because one of the things that people will, of course, the biggest difference between Hundley and, say, Beathard is the fact that Hundley has been there under the same system, behind the same quarterback now for over 2 years. So we would expect him to be a little, shouldn't we? I don't know, maybe not. Shouldn't we expect him to be a little bit more? I don't want to compare, but you see some quarterbacks like Deshaun Watson, who looks like he has been around for a couple of years, but everybody's different. I get that. But shouldn't we expect maybe a little bit more from him in his first start when he's been there for over 2 years?
Yes, especially from what he's shown in the preseason. Now, again, the preseason is not the live action that you see during a regular season game or certainly the playoffs, but it gives you some feeling about how a guy does. And Brett did a nice job in the preseason for a couple of years. And the thing is, you're right. You expected more. We didn't get it. The Packers end up running the ball using Aaron Jones, giving him, an opportunity. He went over 100 yards, and that's what they should do.
Yeah.
The running game has got to pick up some of the slack, and then the defense has got to pick up slack, which they didn't do. I think the Packers defense gave up like 485 yards or something, and you know, it's got to be a total team thing. They can't expect, you know, him to be Aaron Rodgers, because Aaron Rodgers,
no.
you know, wins games by just getting out of bed and walking over to the stadium, you know?
Yeah, that's why they are going to have to learn how to play better defense and continue to run the ball to give him a chance. So, because you talked about consistency. You also said in your report from a couple of years ago that he needed to improve his footwork and decision-making. So what did you notice on Sunday with both?
Well, I think that, you know, his footwork has shown some significant improvement. But, again, you've got to do it every single play. And, you know, I think he probably did it about 60% of the time, had his feet under him. And, you know, he had when he was throwing the ball, you know, not throwing off the back foot and things. And you know, the thing is, see, the fans can, with Aaron Rodgers being out, Aaron Rodgers makes things look so smooth and on tempo and on rhythm. And, you know, Brett Hundley can't do that right now. And he needs to do that because, you know, that's what he is. He's a rhythm type guy. And that's what I was talking about, consistency. He may have, you know, two or three games where, you know, he's going to look pretty good. And then sometimes he just drop off the map, you know. So, but everything is a flash with him. He just needs to, you know, become overall consistent in his total game.
Yeah, I mean, because, like, I know you also had mentioned Watson had inconsistent footwork in college, and that is probably why he was also very inconsistent with his passing. And again, though, he's been able to make it work at this level. Now, I'm sure he still has a long way to go, especially with footwork. So is that, while you're developing footwork, what other parts of a game then can Hundley make up for that, say, a player like Watson has been able to make up for?
Well, I think the thing is getting in rhythm and with your feet under you, and being able to see the offensive coordinator can help out quite a bit too. And sometimes you get stuck, like in that West Coast offense, like they run at Green Bay.
Okay.
You know, it's not like 1-2 and out.
Okay.
You know, it's sometimes, you know, things, you do things with play action and your footwork with your fakes and things like that. And
so is it more difficult? Is it a more difficult offense for a young quarterback to learn?
It is. It is. And, you know, I remember when I was with Philadelphia, you know, Andy Reid and Gruden, when Gruden was there before Reid, you know, they used to always say that it takes 3 years for a rookie quarterback to play in this system. And, you know, that's why they always wanted to try to go after a quarterback that knew the West Coast offense.
Okay.
And even though a guy wasn't as talented as maybe the guy that was already there, you know.
Sure.
So, but yeah, it does take some time, and like I said, you know, Hundley was drafted in 2015, so hey, his time's about 3 years in now.
And he played what, under the pistol offense at UCLA?
Yes.
So what's the big differences besides that offense and the one that he's playing with McCarthy?
Well, it's the spread offense, and then what the pistol is he's back in the shotgun. But then he has the running back right behind him.
Okay.
You know, he's not like at the side, like a lot of spread offenses. And so it's basically was built to run the ball.
Okay.
Okay. And then run play action passes and things like that. And, you know, another guy that actually made the pistol famous was Colin Kaepernick.
Yeah.
You know, when he was at Nevada, the coach.
That was Chris Ault. That was his. Yeah,
yeah.
Chris Ault. Yeah. Uh-huh.
He was from, you know, and so it was the same type of offense. And but anyway, Huntley, you know, he was in that type of spread offense, but he's had a lot of time, you know, some off seasons and things learned. But that's another thing. You know, we talk about these quarterbacks struggling, and hey, the coaches don't have as much time to spend with them according to the collective bargaining agreement.
Yeah,
that was,
yeah.
You know,
and he's a backup too, and he's a backup. So yeah.
Yeah. So that's another sticky wicket.
Yeah, and by the way, if you were an opposing GM, and okay, he's been there for 3 years. He's only got about another, year, I think? And then he's going to be a free agent, possibly. That's a possibility. So if Aaron Rodgers is there another 3 or 4 years, then you get into the same situation that we're seeing, like, with A.J. McCarron with Cincinnati, I mean, or even what we saw at New England with their quarterback situation with Garoppolo. So if you're a GM and you're looking for these types of quarterbacks and you're looking at Hundley this season and you're thinking a year from now, maybe I could get him. What is it that you're looking for? What do you want to see from him to get better? Besides, you know, what we just talked about. Well, you know, what kind of production? What is it that you're looking for?
Well, the thing is, if I'm running the West Coast offense, you know, I want to see him do things fundamentally correct within that offense. You know, whether even if it's in the preseason, and now he's getting a chance for his game. I mean, that's but see. The sticky wicket there, too, is like Flynn did well in the West Coast offense at Green Bay. If he had a few really good, you know, games there and got him a big contract, then he goes to, Seattle, and he isn't even in the same stratosphere as Russell Wilson. So, you can look good, but you have to remember, you know, everybody's not Brett Favre or Aaron Rodgers.
All right. And is there, so far from what you've seen from him, again, it's only a game, but and from what you remember about what you saw him in college, do you have confidence that he's going to be able to improve and potentially become a starting quarterback? If you had a more 50-50, yes or no?
I would say no right now, but that's because he hasn't really been under fire as much, like in preseason. Like I said, he did some good things and showed pretty good accuracy there. But, you know, he does have some receivers. He does have a tight end,
yeah,
you know, in Bennett. He doesn't have a great running game, but even though, you know, Montgomery is supposed to be their bell cow, but and then, you know,
Jones is sure looking good now,
yep,
so
– He's got something there, so
yeah.
He can't carry a team. Let's put it that way.
Yeah, he's not that type of quarterback, and nor do you think he's going to be that type of quarterback. Okay.
No.
I mean, he does have the athleticism. I think that's the one thing we saw in this game that could be an advantage. I mean, for a guy that has a little bit of size, that is something that he's going to have to use, isn't it? If he's going to be effective.
Yep. Yeah, and he's a very good athlete, and I think he works hard at the quarterback spot, but until, you know, and I may be 100% wrong, he may come throwing bullets here, you know, by the end of the year, and that'd be great. So, you know, but it's just going to, you know, again, everything has got to fall into place for him.
All right, Dan, I appreciate your time. Thanks for giving us insight on Hundley, and we'll be talking to you next time.
You betcha. Thank you, Greg.
Thank you. All right, so that will do it. I'm Greg DePalma. Thanks for listening to Dan Shonka's Scouting Section on the Arledge Football Radio Network, where it's never too early to think about the NFL Draft. Go to arledge.com, order a subscription of your choosing, including the 2018 Arledge NFL Draft Preview Brochure that's available right now. And thank you for tuning in to the Arledge Football Radio Network.